idea. Let's spend the afternoon in Stuttgart, now on BBC Two, with Matt Baker.
Welcome back to the World Gymnastics Championships here in Stuttgart. We are live, and what a day it was for Great Britain yesterday in the individual apparatus finals. A full house, a gold, a silver and a bronze, courtesy of Max Whitlock and the Downey sisters.
It's so important, this first pirouette. Clean, into the next move.
Up into the handstand, that's good work, the Bosnari skill. Well, very powerful and explosive gymnast. Just look at this, what a start! That was two fantastic vaults from Ellie Downey. He gets through the routine, that's the one to watch.
That is, without question, the score to beat.
Just needs a clean dismount. Well done, Becky Downey, so well performed.
Max Whitlock is world champion. So Becky Downey, a silver, Ellie Downey, a bronze, and Max Whitlock, three times world champion. And talk us through the last day of finals here is another three times world champion. Beth Tweddle, what a day it was yesterday, Beth. I mean, we haven't stopped talking about it, have we?
No, I mean, it's magical to see Max back on top of the world. You could see how much it meant to him. And Obviously for the Downey sisters, for them to both pick up their first individual world medals, it was an amazing day.
It was, and actually it was the most successful day at a World Championships since your time.
When you that was a long time ago.
Yeah, with Lewis and Dan Purvis as well, and yourself winning a gold. It's been a long time coming.
It has, and we've seen the results, we've seen the potential, and I think everything just came into place yesterday for all three of them. And it was for me to be able to sit here and watch it and kind of see the journey that all three of them have been on is amazing.
Well, we're going to talk more about that as we go throughout this afternoon. But actually, up until yesterday, they weren't even on the medals table. And now here, Great Britain are in third place. Here we go, we'll get that up for you now. So USA, Russia and Great Britain there in third. But again, you know, to do all of that, get all of those medals in one day, Beth.
Yeah, the amount of people that are coming up and saying, oh, what an amazing day for British gymnastics.
Yeah.
It is, and it's, I don't think people realise the amount of support network around these gymnasts. Obviously, we've got the team out here, but you've got all the support staff behind the scenes, medical. We've seen Dominic had to kind of fight back through injury from the beginning of the year to be able to be fully fit here. So there's so many, all of the personal coaches, all the clubs at home, and I know each and every one of them will be sat watching and glued to the TV.
And there
weekend.
Are a couple of chances today as well to get up onto the medal podium. Let's just give you an idea of the order of play and how things are looking here. So Dom Cunningham, he's going to go in the first final up on vault alongside a very decorated field. Simone Biles looks for her 18th world title and to become the most successful gymnast ever on this, the last day of apparatus finals. Joe Fraser, he's going to be up on P-bars for Great Britain. He's qualified in third. Now, could he become Great Britain's first ever P-bar medalist? We will find out at around 125. Women's floor, that's always one to watch, and we're going to finish on a high with the high bar. That will be the last final. It's kind of the blue ribboned event here at the World Championship. So from all of those, Beth, things that you're looking forward to, because obviously we're at the World Finals here, so there's a lot more to talk about than just GB gymnasts.
Yeah, I mean, obviously I think everyone's looking forward to seeing Simone, especially on floor, this triple-double that she's been showing every single day. And you would think by this day, she's tired.
You
but
would,
I've seen
you?
I've seen her warm up and she does not look tired at all. You can see here two somersaults with the three twists in it. And just incredible to be able to have that amount of power, that much of spatial awareness be able to perform.
She's going to be on beam before that, and I mean, she's going to go out. And it always feels like a real celebration when you see Simone on floor, because everybody gets involved in the floor routine and the music, and the way she just kind of exudes a face, a smile. How she can keep smiling when she's doing that kind of gymnastics is a feat in itself.
And I get that shows how confident she is with the skills that you're performing, because sometimes you see gymnasts out there that they know they can get through the routines, but only just about get through them. Whereas with Simone, you never have a doubt that she's going to run out of energy or anything, and that smile and the kind of presentation that she has with all of her gymnastics, it's great and such a good role model for all our younger gymnasts coming up.
So, Biles aside, who else are you looking forward to seeing?
Definitely looking forward to seeing Flavia from Brazil. Unfortunately, Brazil didn't quite make it through to the Olympic qualifications, so they would have been disappointed there.
Yeah.
But we've seen Flavia coming up through the ranks. She was the kind of young and up-and-coming star in Rio, and she's had a great championship, so it'll be great to see her in both beam and floor. And during the all-around, the audience absolutely loved this floor routine, so I think it'll be one to look out for.
Yeah, so this women's floor final will be coming up for you a little bit later on. Ooh, did well to stay in. Did well. This is, actually, when you look at all these dynamic tumbles, that's half the challenge these days. We actually saw that with Simone Biles, didn't we, in the all-around final, just to contain the power.
Yeah, because they have got a very bouncy floor, but then obviously add adrenaline on top of that, and they do get a bit of a kickback off the floor, so if they don't land in the correct position, we saw it with Dominic, unfortunately, in floor final yesterday, just kind of rebounds them back, so they need to get that landing spot on.
Well, if you weren't watching yesterday, I'm sure you've seen it on the news, because Max Whitlock yesterday won back his World Pommel Horse title. He's the first Briton ever to win three world titles on the same piece of apparatus. Let's just have a look back at the king on his horse. And here is Max getting that medal. All of that hard work, all of that effort, and that is the result. Three times world champion. And I am over the moon to say that Max Whitlock is right alongside me now. Incredible,
thank
Max.
Thank you very much.
You joined us about 5 minutes ago. You watched that play out. Sorry to put you through that, but the emotion, I mean, that you're still feeling right now. Did you expect it to be this emotional turning up at these World Championships?
No, not at all. And I think, like I explained yesterday, and even today, it still feels like it feels obviously still surreal. But the feeling feels so different to any other result for some reason. I think there's a lot of reasons that do go into that. A lot of things in terms of 2018, with it not going 100% to plan, like
that's
getting silvers. And the criticism from there, and everything goes into it.
So trying to win it back then has been a really big deal for you?
Because it's not just, you know, proving it to everybody that I can still do it. It was proving it to myself as well. And I haven't scored my target score, what I wanted to score on pommels for probably over a year now, and that was kind of getting to me inside without me saying it to anybody, because my target is always to focus on my job and focus on trying to put out the biggest score that I possibly can, and it just wasn't happening at the competitions to what I wanted it to be.
And actually it didn't happen in the team final either, did it?
No, it didn't, and I can get a lot of confidence from this competition, and I always say, you know, I look back at my comps where I get results, I achieve what I've wanted to achieve, and that can calm me moving forwards, and this definitely can, because making a mistake in team final, that added to the pressure on my apparatus final, definitely on pommel horse, because once you get to the skill that you fell on previously, you've got that in your head. And now I know that I can do that after a mistake, it calms me even more, and that's a really good thing going into sort of next year.
And initially at the beginning, where you took a step down off the top of the handle, you said you know, when you were watching it, I don't know why I did that. Were you thinking about that move that was coming up that didn't go your way in team final?
I'm not sure. I think there's a lot of things that go into it. You know, I definitely know I need to work on a couple of things moving forward, in terms of cleaning things up more, which is nice to know that I have that margin in it. But what's really good is that because my start score, basically my start score allowed me to counter mistake. Because my start score was 5 to 6 tenths above the other field, it meant I could get a 3 tenths mistake at the beginning and still come out with a result, which I'm really pleased with. So for me, that's huge motivation moving forward to try and, you know, obviously clean it up even more and try and make that target score a possibility and a reality.
And then all you had to do was sit and watch everybody else go.
That was the hardest bit.
Oh, man. I heard you saying afterwards that you thought, you know, you were going to faint. You were saying about pins and needles in your hands.
I've never felt anything like that. I mean, watching that and... it's kind of weird, and the reason why I say it was different, I feel like I'm going lightheaded now. Like the feeling was unbelievable because it was so intense. And like I said, I'd never really watch any other competitors, so I don't really know other people's routines in the ins and outs or how they do them or anything. So watching it was really, really intense for me.
Yeah.
And I was feeling lightheaded. Like you said, I got pins and needles in my fingers. I felt like I was really ill. I felt awful. But good in the same time because I was happy with my routine.
Yeah.
The feeling, the emotion was going through me like crazy. Seeing the scores come up and, you know, at the bar where they tally it up and is it going to beat me, is it not? And, you know, I knew it was going to be close.
Yeah.
And that's what's giving me motivation to move forward and hopefully increase that margin.
Is that how you felt with your third World Championship title as well, Beth?
I think it's always harder when you go up first and you have to just sit and watch your other competitors. Because I was the same in competition. You didn't want to watch anyone else. The audience were kind of what gave it away. If you heard a huge clap, you were like, oh, they've done really well. If you heard then you knew they'd failed. So, I guess. But I don't know how he does it, having had just... a brand new baby and
this is the amount of emotion with that. You're saying you're doing this for Willow. We played out these lovely little shots yesterday. And just to see the pair of you at home there. And actually, your perspective on your gymnastics has changed since she's come along.
I need to go back and watch this because I haven't seen this properly. I can't wait to get home and see her. But yeah, it has. I mean, a lot of people say it. You know, having a baby puts a lot of things into perspective, and it's not until you actually have a baby that you know you really do realise that.
Yeah.
That she means everything to me, and the motivation, the inspiration to keep going and keep pushing, for her, she's my biggest little fan now, and it's just something. It's even more reason to do it. So it's quality.
Well, she's gonna love this medal in particular because it's so shiny. I mean, it lights up these medals. They're incredible, aren't they? These?
They are actually. It's one of the best design of a medal that I've ever seen before. It's incredible. And in the dark, it looks unbelievable.
There's a little USB charger at the side so you can charge it up when your gold medal runs out. It's absolutely incredible. Yeah, it really is. Well, Max,
thank you very
much. Huge congratulations. You can now just, I guess, relax and just think to yourself, you know what?
Yeah.
I'm 3 times world champion on the pommel off. That's no fluke.
No, thank you very much. And I can relax and enjoy this comp going on now because we've got more boys on today, which is amazing. And these boys, Dom and Joe, on today, have got huge potential.
Yeah.
With Dom's obviously previous result was 4th in the last Worlds. And, you know,
he can do it. And Joe as well. Your P-Bar's third highest qualifier.
P-Bar final. I have to say, P-Bar final is one of the hardest finals to get into.
Yeah.
And the margins are so squeezed and he qualified in such a high position. So he's got, you know, all the chance in the world and hopefully for Team GB we can get even more medals.
There's a lot of history being written here. It's honestly, it's just a magical, magical World Championships. And talking of history makers, Simone Biles, hopefully today will become the most successful gymnast at a World Championships ever. That's male or female. Here's a story so far.
Simone Biles, if you know before this competition, you sure are going to know her name after this World Championships.
Oh, well, just a quick word, Beth, on Simone Biles about, you know, making history and becoming the most successful gymnast ever, 24 world medals.
Yeah, for me, I really hope she does it. She deserves that title so much. And I've seen her warming up. She's looking calm. She's looking composed. And, I think she'll pick up 2 medals today.
That's what you're going for, two golds?
Yeah.
Why not? It's Simone Biles, for goodness sake. Well, the men are just about to come out.